Good afternoon from a very familiar setting. It's race day here in Spain, and with everything still to play for in the championship battle, there's no room for mistakes in a Grand Prix that's well known for creating them. The Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya then, a high-speed 2.89-mile circuit which demands an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Renault. We have a number of changes to the aerodynamic regulations this year, and the signs haven't looked good for them so far in terms of getting to grips with those changes.
There are a few downcast looks within the team this weekend. I think they've been hit fairly hard by the new regs, but this is only the first step down a long road of development, and even if they don't maximise their points today, there are plenty more up for grabs this season.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Kimi Raikkonen's perfect lap yesterday sees him start from pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Hamilton, and McLaren, and Vettel, Bottas, Hülkenberg, Sainz, and Sergio Perez, Ocon, Alonso, Charles Leclerc, and Magnussen, Grosjean, Gasly, Lance Stroll, and Brendan Hartley, Ericsson, and Sergei Sorokin rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Good result last race. Let's try to go one better this weekend.
McLaren. Tak opět vypaleva navíc. Včera v kvalifikaci jsem dokázal zajet. Myslím, že to byl asi šestý nejrychlejší čas. A sem jste mohli vidět Fernando Alonso, který byl v kvalifikaci nejrychlejší, ale penalizace ho odsunula až na 12. místo. Každopádně už mlčím.
What happened? Let me know you're okay.
Vůbec nešetřila. No. Tak zase nás bude čekat restart.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long.
Jasně. Zase mě sešrtoval Hulk, jak se někdy Nico Hülkenbergovi přezdívá.
Thank you.
Softs. To leader, 4.3 seconds. Right, come in at the end of this lap. To the car in front is 3.1 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound.
kapitén, to jsem nechtěl. Alonso, ku podivu, pořád mě zajímavé boční. Žlutá vlajka. Někdo odstupuje? Ne? Pojďme se si podívat, jaký byl důvod pro vyvěšení žlutých vlajek. Jaký byl důvod? Vyvěšení žlutých vlajek. Tady stojí nikoho, má šálu. Krachem kontaktu.
Is 5.6 seconds.
A ano, to si nemohl vybrat. Lepší pozici na parkení. Je mi za tohleto strašně líto. A to je to.
Virtual safety car, virtual safety car, reduce.
Co se stalo, jak to se přihodilo Sergeji Sirotkinovi? Zase technika.
Okay, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Fernando's in for his stop. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Gap to car in front is 4.9 seconds. The car ahead has come in and fitted the soft tire. target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. Is 6.8 seconds. Nice move. Good job. Teammate by 7.7 seconds. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. Front wing damage. Is 14.3 seconds. race is 29.5 seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 21.4 seconds. Laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Okay, good work, great pass. Oh. moment is 27.2 seconds. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Here's our winner, pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari, on the top step once more. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Kimi Raikkonen, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Kevin Magnussen. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.
Kalau itu terkepat dulu, lebih pas besar dia keluar kena. Dia berarti memang bertuan ke kita. Akhirnya kita apa menebut aku dengan kita tahu kebenarnya. Bikin bertuan ini. Nah, kalau ini cek bermanis seperti cek yang saya tahu dan saya kena bisa. Dan anda menggunakan termasuk juga boleh jadi kalau termasuk karet saya masih cuba main di atas monitor atau seperti berarti sampai Estimanto, Menstro, Romain Rosa, Marcus Eston, Brandon Matei, Nico Hülkenberg, dan Kurnia, Asi Opel de Pacuna, Tip Topi, mungkin Sergio Bukit Nijewo, Bodoh, Lentro, Pienter Flynn, Nico Hülkenberg, Brandon Hartley, Aya, Oke.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. Do you have any comments about the collisions? Your battle got a bit heated, didn't it? Well, thanks anyway.
Team of three, but it was never about showmanship. Tak na to jim budu kačát, budu sportsmanship. Dím se, že se to rovnou nepoužil, když jsem závodil za Williams. Prostě jsem už raději ten sportsmanship. No, už jsem prakticky poražený v rivalitě, ale když jený ukončuje rivalitě mezi mnou a Charlesem Leclerkem, asi to nebyl dobrý nápad opět mít Leclerka za rivala.
We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend.
Teď už to je nemožný prakticky, abych Monaku získal byly 40 bodů, maximum je 25. Ale já totiž v Monaku ani jednou nebodoval. Tak. A nedostatek bodů. Pozor. Takže nemám dostatek bodů na vývoj. A můžu si to byl tady u motoru. 19.22 bylo na poslední oddělení. Jdeme na to. Motor se na to velice špatně. A do ne, vlastně do Francie, já totiž... Jasně. Tady to opět pojedu splnit s trpalovacím motorem, ale velmi těsné to bude s převodovkou. 54% po 5 povinných závodech. Teď jen budu doufat, že to vydrží. Na ty poznámkový závody mám seru úplně. Jděte s tím do prdele.
Okay, we had the new parts come through from the factory. We'll get them on the car ahead of FP1.
Jsme poodskočili zase Ferrari, ale název závody Monaco a tam to může dopadnout úplně všechno. Tam víme, že to dopadne úplně všechno jinak. Stále si držíme pozici, že jsme nejlepší v aerodynamice. Druhé nejlepší šasí a s motorem se minimálně jak do Francie posuneme. Zase víš, pod námi Force India, Toro Rosso a Mercedes. No, každopádně to je už všechno pro dnešní video. Děkuji, že jste se dívali a zatím nasledanou.